So let's talk about the PlayStation 4. A lot of us have been getting worried since February about what Sony was going to do with the system. It was evident from their press conference that A, they learned a lesson from the PlayStation 3 episode,
$999,
and B, they paid close attention to Microsoft's Redmond campus catastrophe, focusing on TV, sports, a water cooler, and a real SEAL team dot, you know what? I've said that enough times, so let's focus on the PlayStation 4. I was entirely impressed by the press conference. Looks like there's going to be a couple of good exclusives. Order 1886 looked amazing that I'm interested in. However, there aren't enough exclusives for me right this second to jump in, especially if the multiplats are coming out on the PC. So my PC rig is much, much faster than the current console generation. With the PlayStation 4, Sony has placed their bets with the gamers. It was revealed and looked like a rhombus, reminiscent of the fat PS2 model. I hereforth call it the rhombus. There were unconfirmed rumors that Sony would allow publishers to lock out used games, though it was also confirmed that Sony does not have an option like that in the PS4 to, quote, lock out, unquote, used games. That source comes from videogamer.com. So that's cool. I can rent, loan, share, and buy PlayStation 4 games as illustrated in Sony's sarcastic 22-second commercial of the CEO handing the SCEA CEO a game showing how games are shared on the PlayStation 4. It has garnered viral attention among gamers and is linked in the video description. I thought it was very classy. Well played, you trolls. Well played. PS4 does not come with a camera. There is a camera peripheral, but it's only for the PlayStation Move and stuff that I'm not really interested in anyways. You won't have to go online to register your games or download them. The game is on the disc and you can play the games off the disc or install them into the upgradable HDD. You stick the game in, you play. That's how it should be. You will need to pay $4 to $5 a month if you want to play multiplayer, though. PlayStation Network was free for PlayStation 3, servers are no longer free, and Sony wants money. However, the people that are saying, oh, I'm not buying PS4 anymore, well, guess what? With the $4 to $5 a month, you're getting free games and goodies offered, and as long as the server quality improves with this payment, I'm okay and I'm on board with this. It makes me feel valued, and remember, that's very, very, very important. You could hook the thing up to the internet and be done with it if you really want to. Get different streaming apps and watch the content stream through your console. No other fees or nickel or diming here. PlayStation Plus is not required to operate multimedia, just the multiplayer through your video games, as confirmed by Sony at the press conference. Unlike its competitor, the Xbone, the PS4 is centered on gaming, but offers you that social media experience and the options if you want them. They're there, they're not complicated, but they're not featureless either. The primary focus is on getting in, playing the game, and making that experience great if you want DLC or multiplayer through the PlayStation Plus. The PlayStation 4 will not be backwards compatible with the PlayStation 3, sadly. However, Gaikai will launch in 2013. Gaikai is the streaming service which will allow you to stream PlayStation 3 games through to your PS4 from the cloud. I'm just going to pass on Gaikai and just hook up my PlayStation 3. I mean, thanks, but I just see no point. Rack up my internet bill, will you? Cloud gaming will be available in the future in 2014, according to Sony. Now, where the company really shines is their strong support for indie gamers, and this is critical that they're supporting this slightly tangent brand. The industry is already buzzing, and I'm talking about the indie gaming industry, is already buzzing about the PlayStation 4 and how easy and friendly it is to develop for the system. The PS4 will have dedicated DDR5, which is graphical memory used for the sole purpose of generating pixels and doing graphics card stuff. Nice touch, Sony. Your competitor doesn't have it. Your competitors don't have it. The system, of course, will be Blu-ray capable. In this 8th generation, Sony has moved on and will not be offering traditional composite cords. So now those red, white, yellow cords are SCARTs. You're not getting them anymore. So long! We're now in the HDMI age. At the conference, Sony dropped a huge bomb on the convention center. The PS4 will retail for a respectable $399 to thunderous applause. That's $100 cheaper than their competitor, Microsoft. This is gonna get good. For a console, I'm impressed with what Sony has to offer. This generation proves that gaming consoles are becoming more like PCs, both in capabilities and architecture. Will I be buying a PS4? Yeah, they sold me on it, but I'm not going to buy it right now, probably in a year or two. I'm just not ready to jump into it right now, but I will definitely jump into it early in its lifespan. It offers what I want as a gamer. It makes me feel good about doing it. They've done a good job catering to gamers, and will ultimately be the sheeple buying the console this holiday season who will determine if it is a success or not. Despite the stupidity of the common sheeple, they are getting smarter with internet and tech purchases, and I bet Sony is about to sell pallet loads and they will not be able to keep up. And the price they are offering it at is awesome. It's only $40 or $50 more than its competitor, the Wii U, but, sorry guys. PS4 blows it out of the water in terms of the hardcore gaming experience on a console. So, my final verdict, I highly recommend the PlayStation 4. Look into it.